Hey everyone, I'm Leslie Richardson from the Visual Studio Extensibility team. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create your very own private gallery in Visual Studio 2022. So why even create a private gallery? What even is it? So if you've ever written an extension that you didn't want to release to the world publicly, either via the VS Marketplace or some other location, and you only wanted to share it with a select group of people, like maybe your team or your company, then a private gallery allows you to do just that. It's essentially a privatized version of the VS Marketplace, allowing select people to install and uninstall extensions that you specify. So let's check it out. So the first step that you're going to need to do to create your private gallery is create an empty folder. Ideally, you want to place this folder somewhere that's going to be easily accessible for the people you intend to share that gallery with. I'm going to make mine local, but feel free to place your folder either in a OneDrive or a SharePoint or anything like that as well. So let's call mine my private gallery. So the next thing we need to do is actually populate that folder with the V6 files that correspond to the extensions that you want displayed inside the gallery. So luckily I have a few on standby. Add those in. Now from here, the crux of the entire gallery is based on this XML file called an Atom feed file. So this is very similar to an RSS feed that you might see with podcasts or websites and stuff like that, that will keep a record of all of my V6 information that needs to be displayed in that gallery. And once you share out that file path or that corresponding URL with the people who you need to have access to this gallery, they can all get that same updated information as you continue to iterate on your gallery or update any of the extensions within it and all that jazz. So there are a couple ways to create this file. The first is manually, which is not the most fun option, but if you want to do that, all power to you. Or you can also just have that XML generated automatically via a third-party tool. So for instance, Mads Christensen has a private gallery creator. This is an executable that you can just run within your folder. Or if you prefer the first-party options, we recently added a new tool called the V6 util tool, which is short for the V6 command line utility tool. So that's what I'm going to demo today. All right, so in order to use the V6 util tool, first is you're going to have the build tools NuGet package installed, which is this one right here. And then we're going to navigate to where that NuGet package got installed. Mine by default showed up under my user profile, but your mileage may vary. And we are going to go from that package to the latest version or whatever you installed, followed by tools, VS SDK, bin, and you should see the executable right there. But we can't just run that executable file from here. So instead, we're going to copy paste this path. And then in any terminal of your choice, you can use PowerShell. I'm going to use developer command prompt. We're going to navigate to that location. And from here, we are going to write the following command. So let's do v6 util. And then the keyword today is create v6 feed. And this is what's going to generate that XML file. And now I need to indicate the source. So where is that XML getting its information from? In this case, I want the path for my private gallery folder that I made. And then indicate where I want the XML file to end up. So I'd like it to end up in that same folder. And then finally, let's name the XML Atom feed. _test. So there we go. It tells me that the feed has been created successfully. It even gives me the path of the XML, which I'm going to go ahead and copy right now because we're going to need it later. And if you're curious, you can go back to your folder where you output the XML. So a bunch of icons have been generated as well, but we also have this XML file that you can open up and take a look at if you need to. So yeah, as you can see, this is storing all of the related data for each extension that is going to be included in your private gallery. And this is the critical file. Without this file, nobody else will be able to see the private gallery. But we're not done yet because we still need to actually get the gallery to show up in Visual Studio. So in order to do that, we need to go into Tools, Options, and then search for Extensions. And you'll notice that if you scroll up a little bit, there is an additional extension galleries block right here. So we're going to add a gallery like so. I'm going to call my gallery my first private gallery. And from here, you can either add a URL link that corresponds to that XML that you generated, or in my case, a file path. And that's what I just copied earlier. So we're going to apply that. And so there it is. This may look like you're done because it showed up here, but that is not true. So in order to test it out and make sure that it actually works, we can go into extensions and then the extension manager. And just like you'd be able to browse in the VS Marketplace for extensions that you want, you can now do the exact same thing in your own private gallery. So you can download, install, uninstall extensions here, but only it's exclusive. It's the VIP experience for a select group of people. So this is really cool. And what's great about having this RSS feed style XML file is once you, again, choose to update any of these extensions, all you need to do is run that same create V6 feed command and update your V6s, and everybody will get access to that same information. So that is how you create your very own private gallery in Visual Studio 2022. So the next time you have an extension that you don't want the whole world to see, be sure to check out making a private gallery and only sharing it with a select group of people. And you can learn more by checking out the related docs. So until next time, happy coding.